Thanks for returning. I hope this video finds you happy and doing well. As you know by the thumbnail, this video is going to be on my top spring eyeshadow palettes. So if you're interested, then just keep watching. All right, so I decided to go through my collection, and while I do have a lot of palettes that I feel would be great for spring, I decided to pick out the top ones that I feel would be best, or either the ones that I'm liking the most for spring. So I do have a little bit of something for everybody, from affordable to high end. You're gonna find something in this list, and I'm not gonna go in any particular order. So let me just go ahead and get started. The first one that I wanna talk about is from Dominique Cosmetics, and this is her Rustic Glam eyeshadow palette. Here are the shades, and as you can see, you get some blues in here. You get like baby blues in a deeper tone, as well as a lighter tone. You do get some good transition shades, as well as like a black shade that does have the little gold type of silvery flakes in it. Some people don't like them, others do. It just depends. I think that they're pretty, and I do like how you also get some greens in here, even though it's kind of muted, and some mauve and some pink tones. This would be a super cute palette for spring. Pair it with a blue dress or even a yellow dress, and it would just be totally gorgeous. Next, I have the You Had Me at Aloha by Kara Beauty. This is one of her duo palettes, and actually I have two more that I want to show you, but this palette would be perfect for spring, especially if you like pink. I like this particular brand's formula. I find that they layer really well and they blend out really good. The metallics are really nice as well. They're not the most blinding on the market, but they're definitely nice. And I really do like how in this palette you get the gradient type of effect. So if you wanted to stick with a monochromatic look, you could definitely do so. But this is super adorable for spring. The other one that is in this collection is the Gentle Teaser. So this one would be good if you like the peachy tones, if you like the monochromatic palettes. This one has a black, and let me tell you, this brand's blacks are really good, very pigmented, and when you apply them, they show up as black. But I really like how you get the peachy, pinky, orangey type of tones in here. Just really pretty for spring. Pair this with that shade of a dress or some jeans and a top that is the same color as one of these shades in this palette, and it would just be totally, totally gorgeous. And then the last one in this collection, or that I have, is Havana Club. And this would be good if you like the greens, the purples, the blues. You get a really nice mixture, but specifically if you like the greens, I think. And the metallics in here pair really well. I like how they're nice and vibrant, very appropriate for spring. Even their deeper tones right here are really good to mix in, so you can have something that you can use as a transition, or even if you want to use it as a liner, just however you want to use it, these palettes would go really good for spring. And I just recently picked these up at TJ Maxx. I would definitely say check TJ Maxx before you buy them off of the website, because you can get them so much cheaper. The next one that I have is by Morphe, and this is the Avani Gregg palette. This one is new to my collection, but when I saw it, I had to have it because it screams spring. You get the cake liners at the bottom, and you get the nice mattes at the top. You get one glitter in the middle and two metallics over there in the corner. Now, what I really like about this palette is that most of it is matte, and then of course you get the cake liners, and the cake liners are nice and neon type of shades. If you're a fan of Morphe's cake liners, I would say to definitely check them out. For the price, I think that they're really good, but this is a really cool palette for spring, and I like how they threw a silver glitter. I'm not a big fan of glitter, but I like how they chose that color, because I think that it pairs perfectly really with each shade in this palette. Super cute for spring. The next one that I had to throw in is the Norvina Volume 3 palette, and even the packaging on this palette screams spring. But look at these colors, so very pretty. Again, you get a lot of nice neon shades in here. For this particular palette, I never have had a problem getting a good look in. I really do like the metallics and the shimmers in this palette. I think that they work best when your brush is wet, but I also like how, even though you do get a lot of bright neon shades in this palette, you still get some of the deeper tones to use as transition colors or just shades to deepen up your outer V or a liner, you know, just however you want to use it. I think that it's a really nice palette, and I'm hoping that the other palettes go on sale soon because I would like to get the other two that are out there. I just don't know if I want to pay $60. Okay, so this next palette is probably hated by most, but loved by me. And this is the Millennial Pinks palette by Melt. And here is the color story. Now, maybe I'm biased because pink and black are my two favorite colors, but I have been able to get some really nice, soft, everyday type of looks with this palette. When I do use these shadows, I do have to set my base. If I don't, it's just not gonna work all that well for me. I really do like the metallics. Now, mind you, I really haven't come across any of Melt's metallics shadows that are blinding or real bright. That's just not their strong suit, but they are very nice for an everyday type of look. You're not going to get anything blinding, but you can get a beautiful monochromatic look with this palette. And I really do like how you get the gradient effect, and they again do give you a black, a gray, and a silver. It's just really nice for spring. Pair this with a white dress or a pink dress, you know, just whatever you want, and you just look cute as a button. The next palette that I have is by Nabla, and this is their Cutie palette in Coral. This is it right here. And this is a super cute 6-pan palette. Of course, the light peachy matte and the peachy metallics scream spring. It's really nice, bright, and airy. And for Nabla, I really do like their formula. They have like a creamy matte, which is a cross between a metallic and a black matte. And that would be this burgundy shade right here. It's just really pretty. While you probably won't just get a lot of looks out of this palette, the few looks that you can get from this one would be perfect for spring. Plus, this shade right here is just so divine. I just want to eat it up. Love it, love it, love it. If you haven't tried any of Nabla's eyeshadows formulas, you definitely have to try it. The next palette that I have is by Kaleidos, and this is their VR Neon palette. Comes in a package like this. And where do you all see this one? This is another one that's got some serious blinding neon shades in here. Plus, you get two metallics. And not sure if you're familiar with this brand's metallics, but they are so bright, so vibrant. You don't even need to wet your brush. They're just beautiful. I use these metallics that I have. I have, I think, five of these eyeshadow palettes, and I like to pull these eyeshadows to pair with other looks that I do because it always makes the look pop. But you can't go wrong with getting a spring look using this palette, especially if you just use these last four. So pretty, just a beautiful look. And I like the packaging too. It's really unique, and I haven't seen a lot of people do packaging like this. All right, so the next one is by Juvia's Place, and this is the Zulu palette. This is another one that has a lot of bright colors in it. Again, when I think of spring, I'm thinking bright colors. Of course, you can get some spring looks with more muted tones, but this is just kind of what I think of. And all of these colors are really pretty, and I especially like how she threw in a brown to use as a crease shade, an outer V shade, just however you need to use it. It would just really help to pull all of these shades together, and I think that this screams spring. I really like this middle row, the different tones of greens that she has, plus the yellow. To do a yellow and a green look would look would be absolutely pretty. You could definitely do a look using those and have you a nice bright green dress or a green top and some jeans and look cute as pie. All right, and the last palette that I have is by Pat McGrath, and this is the Subversive palette. Comes in a package like this, and I know you're probably already side-eyeing me, but with every spring eyeshadow video, you've got to have that spring palette that's good for the evening, and that would be this one. You get your black, you get your brown, you get your specialty shades in peachy gold and like bright gold, old gold. You get like a satin type of cream. This shade would be totally gorgeous. Plus, you can pair a lot of the topper shades, her specialty shades, over other mattes or metallics that you may have. Just take that look to a totally different level. Totally gorgeous and would be perfect for spring. So yeah, that's it, short and sweet. Those would be my picks of spring eyeshadow palettes. Let me know, what spring eyeshadow palettes have you been loving? Let me know down in the comments. I'd love to hear about it. Thank you so much for tuning in, and until my next video, smooches.